is probably a bit unprompted. First time you guys are here, my boys get after the ball. With things as they are, I have a very dumb idea involving this boss mod by Deep and Seth in particular. I'm going to play some Russian roulette in the arcade mode. If I encounter Hakumen, then I encounter Hakumen. This video will go on until I do. God help me.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel 1. Action!
Probably the first time I've actually been using my voice for so long. It's so real fucking dead. How are you guys doing? Hopefully, handling yourself just fine. I'm doing okay. Life. Is live. Just, yeah.
Rebel
2. I'm not very good with small talk. That time, like, I'm trying to focus. So, like, if there's anything else you guys want to see after now, like, I know I still have to work on my different power factor of, like, the war shot is, like, a little bit much. Desired, despite of everything I've found so far. So it's like, not much to really think about. Okay. The mid dispenser. Goddamn it, Kakura.
The
wheel of fate is turning.
Alright.
Rebel 1. Action!
I actually had this game before. It's like a friend of mine. Got out of Steam Zones, like, you know, that's motivation to download the laptop. It's been a very fun experience actually getting back
Rebel
into it.
Two.
And when I learned about the boss mods, like, then I actually have to try. Maybe if I, like, get a handle on some game stuff, maybe I can do it. Do fear battles if I really want to try. There has been no Hakumen. Okay, scripted.
Yep, Tommy.
The wheel of fate is turning.
Story, I don't think
Rebel 1.
We should be waiting on that. So, I guess maybe in the comments, tell me your Blade Blue Man or your favorite fighting game character. Your experiences with fighting games in general. It can be any fighting game. It can be Smash, Rivals of Ether, this, anything really. And like, it can be for superficial reasons, like, this person probably is one of my favorite characters in the series, or maybe really appeal to their personality, or their art style, or their fighting. It could be anything. The real question is now. Okay. Tsubaki. Or Isayoi.
Sweet.
The wheel of fate is turning.
It's kind of a miracle I haven't been Hakumen yet. Doesn't give me much ways in terms of combos, but fortunately, not much can really be said about. Okay. I have survived. Mushroom Life is the next three fights are shipped in.
One. Action!
That's not getting into my good, like, last night. I think this part of the front is it, front or two. Actually doing rounds against that. To get that, it's like, shit's insane. Like, boom, shit grows bigger and bigger until you actually get hit. He will actually perform Time Killer more than once in a round if he has a chance. Sadly, I've been recording those things over playing first matches. And I didn't think to record. Kinda makes me wish I did, because I actually landed a natural feed on him, Aurelius. You walked into that, pal. Never change Kagura. Never change. Okay. There's Ragnit.
The wheel of fate is turning. Level 1. Action!
Kind of making myself wish I knew how to edit more properly, because like I was probably going to do this in post. It's just like trying to focus and talk at the same time. It's like awkward. Ow. That was almost a perfect. Alright, who's our next one? Okay, just Tager. Yeah,
that's right.
The wheel of fate is turning! Rebel 1! Action!
Oh, surprisingly, Act 1 of Russian Roulette now. It was also a tanker match. It's like I just turned butter and man grabbed nothing good out.
Rebel 2.
That's what I do. Now that was a climax.
Sumarai
Koko.
Fine.
Omae wa jibun no kodou ni ginen o kanjita koto.
There we are, well.
Anata ga Kagura Mutsuki ne?
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel 1. Action.
Okay, so far so good. That's Act 1 done. And I should mention, I had to at least look up Act 1 beforehand before I started this, because my plan is I don't want to run into Hakumen if it's scripted, because it kind of just kills the random part, the random chance part of this. But that would mean I can check Act 2 really quickly.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel 1. Action. Action!
Actually, my friend, who's in a well made, is actually singing a Carl. They play as well.
Rebel 2, action!
So, I can actually apply an all-catch stab to this.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel 1, action!
That was fun.
Ora, not to you.
Kagura, win!
Honestly though, on the mod subject,
Rebel
I actually can't wait
two.
To see what they'll do for, like,
action.
What Seth will do for Kagura. Honestly, unlimited Kagura in front of the Tazzle is like the wackest nut job in the world because he had straight up 3 solid moves for his life. His heavy, like, medium fucking track. And he gave them Sonic Hurricane for a distortion drone. And the triple flash kick. So it's like, I honestly want to see what other shenanigans he'll be able to do.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel 1, action!
It's like, no joke. Like, now that I sort of understand Kagura better gameplay wise, I feel like I have a lot more fun.
Rebel 2, action!
Okay. This fight and the next fight, or what's left,
the wheel of fate
before
is
it goes back into scripted territory.
Rebel 1, action! Tornado!
And I guess, really, without dead air, no question next is, what should I do? Like, which boss air should I do after Hawkman. If I actually do end up getting it. Because at this point, I might as well make a hole about it.
Kagura, win! Perfect!
Okay. Yeah, this is like the final fight, scripted. Before scripted, I mean.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel,
words
one.
Suck.
Action. Counter.
Rebel 2, action!
Actually, the better question is, like, which arcane mode should I do next? The Kagura doesn't do it. And the only requirement is they have to have an act where they don't have to be a counter-proxy that can work with a crush on the lead. Again, I'll have to make a poll about it later. So, like, make some suggestions in the comments, and I'll see what I can do.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel one, action.
This feels like something that'll be fun. That's after I counter Hawkman. Now I'll probably have to think about like what character I can relate to. I think Cocker is like one of my up and coming. I've already done all of the bang acts already. Like, the other day, I was doing the interact screen act and I locked the boss against Nine when I was trying to go for fucking Rocket. That didn't go so well.
Rebel 2, action!
At this point, I feel like I might be at a better grasp of what I can do, because it's like, I feel like I'm in my element, just having fun with this game for so long, like not having a chance to play it.
Rebel 2, action!
Okay. course I had to watch on Azrael. Credit. And now for he's a nominee, the one person who is immune to time killing. The greatest fucking canonical interaction I've ever seen in a while. Oh, that's not good. That's not good at all. Screaming. Okay, that's two acts down. Yep. Skipping that. And for Act 3, I'm not going to go for a super boss in Act 3. I'm not that suicidal. Because I know for the second I run into Hakumen, I'm going to lose. Which would be funny. But thankfully, hopefully, that actually happens. And, like, actually, at that point, I'll let Hakumen kill me with fucking Time Killer. It'll be plain funny as shit. Even though it is hell in a handbasket on my computer.
Please select your character. Kagura Mutsuki.
Okay, Act 3. First fight is... Oh no! Oh no! I can't believe I willed it into existence. Well, I guess this is the end, everybody. I had to fight Hakumen. It happened. Well, let's let him do his thing.
The Wheel of Fate is turning.
I'm fucked.
Level 1.
Beyond. Oh, he was going to do that later on there. I can't believe it happened after two acts of stuff.
Rebel,
I'm still trying to get the boom agenda. Action. Come up because, like, you need to see it in act.
Oh god.
I know he's my Raven Slayer, but I want him either to hit me with a Puma Shell. To be fair, this is fine. That's one way to lose. This is fun, but I promise. For now.
Kagura, lose.